Beckoning for Craig Levein and Dundee United. Miksu Patalainen and Hibs haven't given up hope either. This is a Tannadice tussle. They'll both want to win.
Some delivers.
For the last SPL match at Tannadice 2 weeks ago, Dundee United and Celtic shared four goals. Hibs are here this time around, and the battle for European places is back on the agenda. The live match coming up. Between these two this season, it's one win each. United came out on top here in November. Hibs won at Easter Road back in September.
It's fair to say that both these sides have had disappointing starts to the season.
Fletcher! Just over the top by Stephen Fletcher. Right across the back, chance for Fletcher, and he scores!
What a rash tackle by Saul Bamba, and that's going to earn him a yellow card. Sandezza lays it back, Wilkie drives it and it's blocked. Wilkie again with a shot! This time he scores! Derek Riordan, he returns in 2008 to a huge roar. Gomez feeds it through, Sandezza with a chance! Saved by Makalambi. On for Nish, chance now, Fletcher! 2-1 to Hibs! Stephen Fletcher's second of the afternoon. John Daly taken down by Bamba. It's a second yellow and Bamba will be off the field. Hibs have beaten Dundee United by 2-1. Sandezza might get in the end of this one too. Sandezza still with the ball at his feet. Lays it off to Robertson, but he's pulled it wide. Chisholm with a shot, good one too, and pushed away by Zaluska. Inside to Colin Nish, great effort. Cross in this time with a header, finds the back of the net, it's Darren Dodds. Taken in the middle, so Sandezza's header, 2-0. As the referee sounds his full-time whistle, but it's cheers and applause from United fans, and Dundee United, the on-form team at the moment.
Hibs have lost only three of their 13 games in 2009, and yet their first match of the year and their latest game were both impressive 2-2 draws with Celtic.
It's Paul Dixon, it's brilliant! A sensational free kick from Dixon! Launched long by Dixon. Daly tries to flick it off for Feeney. He has! It's 2-2! Dundee United come from 2-0 down. Get back to 2-2.
Inside for Swanson. Oh, he's missed it. Fitzpatrick threads it through. Chance for Porter. 4-0 to Motherwell.
Away come United, Danny Swanson using his pace. Out wide to Sandezza. Can he win it for United at the back post? It's more than Feeney!
Miller. And he shredded it through for Ferguson. Zaluska came out. Lafferty! Rangers set the seal on the victory with Kyle Lafferty's goal.
Better this time, excellent play. Now Robertson. Oh, it's a great finish by David Robertson.
it back for Michael Stewart. He drives it in. Second chance for Stewart. And this time he finds the net. Santaza, good turn. Inside the area, taken down by Edith Jonsson. Here's Santaza. Oh, it's saved by Balog.
It's a decent cross, and a handball from Tam Scobie. Craig Conway stepping up, and Conway has scored. Dundee United score first.
Hills for a penalty, fall on deaf ears. Opportunity for Motherwell on the counter-attack with Klimple to Hughes, to his left-hand side, Jim O'Brien. Clarkson's in the centre. Lovely ball in for him. Clarkson again tries to win the second ball and does! David Clarkson gives Motherwell the lead.
Dixon delivers. And Santaza! Dundee United! Dixon, Santaza, he scored again! Scott Brown rose so well, and it's Lee Naylor with a spectacular volley, it is 2-2!
That's what Craig Levein and Dundee United are capable of when they're on their game, and it's been a funny run of results for them. They're 4 points ahead of today's opponents, Hibs, but they trail Hearts by five. And bearing in mind the quality that United have at their disposal and the way they can play, is that a bit surprising?
Well, I think they've been playing well. I think they've been, you know, producing the goods as far as being able to play football and putting teams under pressure, but they haven't been getting the points to back that up. They've obviously been scoring goals, we've mentioned that, but it's defensively I think they've got their problem, Rob. They've not been really poor defensively, but they've just not been able to keep clean sheets, and that makes a difference when you're going in tight games, and most of these games at the moment are very, very tight. All the clubs can beat each other, so what you have to do when you have that situation is try and keep clean sheets, try and keep it tight at the back, and that's exactly what Hibs have been doing, and they've been managing to get results because of it.
United were looking a stick on for third place in the SPL just a few months ago, but those results recently have been a letdown. Here's Craig Levein with Emma.
Craig, your team produced an impressive second half performance against Celtic in the last SPL outing. Are you looking for that over 90 minutes today to get the victory?
That would be nice, yeah. That's always the intention. You know, we want to play well and score goals. And a similar type of performance would give us a good chance of winning the game.
You've made two changes today, including leaving Lee Feeney on the bench. Were his international exertions obviously in your mind when you made that decision?
If you notice, there's not we don't have a player playing today that played two games last week. Cadis and Goodwillie both played two games, and Warren played two games as well. So I just feel that, you know, international football is not just physically tiring, but emotionally tiring as well. And I think he's had a fantastic week, Warren. And I just feel that we need fresh legs today. I'm not saying you won't see him at any point. I still think he's still on a high after his performances. So we'll probably use that at some point in today's game.
A win today will secure top six football for you for the remainder of the season. How big an incentive is that to take the 3 points?
Well, we want to show the club's moving in the right direction, and two successive top six finishes, for the first time since the split began. As a sign that we're improving, and that's important to me.
Thank you, and good luck today, Craig.
Okay, thank you.
Well, Craig, echoing what Scott was saying there in terms of Dundee United's recent performances, they have been playing pretty well, but results don't match up, and in that respect, they're underachievers at the moment, John, aren't they?
Well, there's not an awful lot. There's only 4 points between the two teams, and if you look at the disgruntledness, if you like, with the Hibs supporters and how much Craig Levein's revered here, if you like, by the Dundee United fans, what a job he's doing. And there's only what one win between the two sides, so it just goes to show, really. But I think, going back to the Warren Feeney being left out today, I think ideally he'd like to play him, but he knows that he's had a tough 10 days, if you like, away with his country. But it's interesting because Daly and Santaza, two big men, if you like. Sadaza's probably a bit more mobile than Daly, and will chase lost causes, but they'll have to play differently. They'll have to look to get into their feet. But they know they've got, you know, the midfielders, Gomez, they know they can play around the corner, and they know it's going to stick with them two big boys up there today.
8 points from the last. The notice of George Burley that with Scotland not exactly well off at left back, Paul Dixon has been looking good for Dundee United. But the player himself is just happy to be settling into the SPL after a summer switch from rivals across the road, Dundee.
I have been pleased. I mean, I knew I had to wait my time when I came here because obviously Danny Granger's here already. So when I got my chance, I feel as though I took it, and I'm happy with how I've done so far in my first season. The biggest one is my defending. I know I've got to work on that, and I know I'm in the right place to, with the right people to help me work on that. So it's ultimately down to me how I apply myself. Whenever I get the chance, I mean, myself and Danny Granger, when he's fit, we go out, we stay behind at St Andrews and we do free kicks or we do crossing. So it all helps us. All last week we were in working on the back four shape, and he just tells us what he wants us to do, and then we'll do a couple of attacks from the midfield, whatever, work on the defence, and then he'll stop it and he'll run through points that he wants to run through with us, whether it's individually or whether it's with the back four as a whole. So it's, he helps us a lot. But he's also worked with the midfielders as well, getting their shape and then incorporating the both of them together so that we know whenever the back four pushes up, the midfield has to push up as well. So we've done a lot of work over the past week and it's been good. I mean, a lot. I mean, with my first season here, making it into Europe at the end of the season, plus it's the club's centenary year next season as well, which would be massive for the club. I mean, when I was younger, I supported United and I followed them, and they were actually in Europe at one point, which was good. So it'd be great to see European football at Tannadice next season. We've got a good young, energetic squad, lots of boys that are hungry for it. So I think we can push on and make that third spot, which is what everybody ultimately is striving to do. But it's also for the fans as well. I mean, they'll obviously, the generations of fans that have come to watch the game, they'll want to be seeing European football as well, so we want to do it for them as well.
So maybe jumping the gun to throw him into the Scotland squad already, but he's shaping up pretty well, isn't he, in his first season in the SPL, Scott?
Well, we are losing players in the Scotland squad, so maybe we do need to draft some in.
Short number.
No, I think he's an excellent left back. You know, the trait that is you know, a necessity now in a good fullback is getting forward and putting balls like that in the box, and there's no shortage of it from him. A young lad who's willing to take responsibility, gets right up there. Long throw specialist. He's got so many attributes to his game. He's got a bit of height, physique. He's got pace. We see this here. Gets himself back at Aidan McGeary, which is no mean feat. And I think just his all-round game for a 22-year-old, delivery into the box, fantastic. I mean, he's got to be a player that George Burley's already got his eye on. There he pops up on the right-hand side with a right-footed cross, great finish from Sandaza, and then a free kick in the net. So if you look at, I mean, that's a great showreel to move on to any club. Not that I'm suggesting that Craig Levein will be looking for that, but he's certainly a player that can both defend and he can actually affect a game going forward.
In midfield for United, he's an international player now, Morgado Gomez. This week he was away with Senegal to play friendlies against Oman and Iran. He's only 23 as well. He's a young player who's come on a ton. How much do you like him, John?
I think he's fantastic, Rob. I really, really do. I think he's a player that we probably don't highlight enough, just really goes about his game. Very rarely gives the ball away. Every time we see him play, he's been excellent. You know, sits in the midfield, keeps it nice and simple, breaks things up, if you like, attacking moves, will put his foot in if he has to. If there's any criticism of him, doesn't necessarily get into the box enough, probably not a big enough goal threat, if you like, but very, very comfortable in possession and a good pass of the ball.
And up top for United, Frans Ndaza. We saw him scoring a couple the last time we were here. 10 this season, 5 of them against the Old Firm.
Yeah, so that suggests that he can score goals, and he can also score goals against the bigger clubs. And what he does do is he gives Craig Levein a little bit of everything up front, because he's mobile, he's got a bit of height in there, he pops up, he times his runs particularly well towards the front post area. I've noticed that with a few of his goals. He just gets that foot in ahead of the defender. So he's a sniffer as well. So he's got all that, he holds the ball up, can link up with other players. And I just feel that he's an all-rounder, that if you can get somebody that really works well with him, then you've got a real partnership up front.
Hungarian midfielder Dennis Rocha is making his
teams, and Dundee United make 2 changes from the Celtic game a fortnight ago. Sean Dillon replaces Michael Kovacevic, and John Daly comes in for Warren Feeney, who's left on the bench after his Northern Ireland exertions. On loan, Paul Caddis is also a sub after playing 2 games for Scotland's under-21s. Morgaro Gomez made his debut for Senegal last weekend, but only came on as a late sub in their midweek match. Fran Sandaza has scored 3 goals in the last 2 games.
Craig Levein knows a win today guarantees his team a place in the top 6, so he's bound to have the players well fired up for this one. The back four will need to tighten things up, as they've conceded far too many goals since the turn of the year. There's not much of a physical presence in midfield, but Dundee United's strong point has always been their mobility. And with Bourbon, Gomez and Conway, they have players who are comfortable in possession. Somewhat of a surprise to see Feeney on the bench after his goals for Northern Ireland last week. Craig Levein has chosen to go with his 2 proven goalscorers, Daly and Sandaza.
Hibs make just 1 change from the Aberdeen game a fortnight ago. Sol Bamba is preferred to David Van Zanten. Gregor Zamatolski faces his former club, having served Dundee United rather well in the first half of last season. Lewis Stevenson has recovered from the ankle knock that forced him out of Scotland's under-21 squad. Stephen Fletcher scored that crucial winner for the senior side against Iceland to make it 3 goals in 4 games lately for club and country.
Hibs come into this game in good form, but with Motherwell breathing down their neck for a top 6 spot, the pressure is still on. Unlike Dundee United, Hibs have looked very strong defensively, and that's a credit to Shamatolski and his back line. Bamba comes in at right back, which could be seen as a risk after his poor performance there against Hearts recently. Rocha and Rankin complement each other well in the centre of the park, allowing Ryan O'Brien to push on. Fletcher and Nish link up again, and that looks to be a combination well capable of causing problems for United today.
Well, he's had quite a week. Time to sit down with the missus, take it easy, and watch some football. Teams aiming to steal a bit of a march. Dundee United have only beaten Hibs twice in 7 years, but one of those victories came earlier this season here at Tannadice, so it can be done. Whoever finishes 3rd and 4th will get a crack at UEFA's new Europa League next season. And a victory for Dundee United today would guarantee a top 6 finish. It's 5th against 6th in the SPL, but wherever you are in the table just now, every match matters.
Yeah, there's no question about that. There's some big games throughout the SPL card today. I'm sure that after these two teams have finished, they'll be keeping an eye on how Hearts get on. They're running away with 3rd place at the moment. And of course, there's a big game at Fir Park with Motherwell playing Aberdeen.
The SPL is back in business. And Gregor Zamatolski is back at Tannadice. He played for Dundee United in the first half of last season when he covered for the injured Lucas Zaluska, his fellow Pole, who himself is leaving these parts for Celtic in the summer, where he'll team up, presumably, with yet another Polish pal in Artur Boritz. Stephen Fletcher scored Scotland's crucial winner against Iceland on Wednesday night, and with 2 and 3 for Hibs, he looks ready to add to his slightly disappointing club tally this season of just 8 goals. Fran Sandaza scored twice against Celtic last time out, moving into double figures for the season. The Spanish striker, who was a reserve at Valencia, has been linked with a return to his homeland with Getafe. Both managers cut their managerial teeth at Cowden Beef. Craig Levein then had a successful stint at Hearts, not so good at Leicester, but has transformed Dundee United. Manager of the Month, Miksu, began his UK playing career here with Dundee United. He joined them as a 20-year-old and spent 4.5 years at Tannadice. Eddie Smith was also in charge when the teams met here in December. The United have toiled since the turn of the year. The Hibs have found some form of late, and they needed to, otherwise they would have been consigned to a bottom six finish. As it is, they are targeting the top six. They have a bit of work to do yet, but a victory for Dundee United today would guarantee them a place in the top six and the chance to have a crack at Europe. Lewis Stevenson, Sean Dillon, making a rare start of late for Dundee United. Stevenson cut out by Wesolowski. Free kick to Sam Darza.
Got to say, it's a lovely surface to be playing on today. Just a drop of rain over the last hour or so. It's put a nice skid on the surface. Perfect playing conditions.
...than some who have been on international duty. Here's Derek Ryden. In fact, there's a nasty injury, I think. And that's why Eddie Smith blew the whistle.
Well, John Daly certainly looks like he's struggling, doesn't he? I think he's looking for a stretcher. I've got a nasty feeling that he might have done his knee, because that was certainly the injury that kept him out long term. He's had problems with his cruciate ligament, and just looking by his reaction, that looked as if he fell very awkwardly and may have twisted it.
Well, Craig Levein's best laid plans could be wrecked inside 3 minutes here. Warren Feeney and David Goodwillie are on the bench, but this does look rather serious. You could tell by the reaction from the other players that this is serious for a man who was injured shortly after arriving at Tannadice, and this doesn't look too clever at all.
No, we can only hope that it's not as bad as it looks, but certainly his reaction told a sorry tale, and he's not moved an awful lot, which is never a good sign.
Well, so much for giving Warren Feeney a rest, although he's certainly on a high after scoring in both of Northern Ireland's matches. Must have thought he was guaranteed a start, having had such a wonderful week, but Craig Levein felt it might be more beneficial to bring him on rather than to start him. Well, he's going to have to come on in the opening minutes anyway, as John Daly is stretched off.
And the interesting thing is, it was such an innocuous challenge. Ball got played into Daly by his fullback, Sean Dillon. It was there to be won. Chris Hogg went through and cleared his lines, and really there didn't seem to be an awful lot in the challenge, and that is often the case when you see these severe knee injuries. It can be just an accidental challenge, and maybe even just the fact that he fell awkwardly.
We will endeavour to get some news on John Daly, but you fear the worst. He's not had much of a rest. Warren Feeney joins us. Having done his bit for his country, Northern Ireland, he hasn't actually scored in 9 games for Dundee United. But after the week he's had, you fancy him perhaps to break that duck. But John Daly's game is over already, and sadly, it looks like his season might be too. Lewis Stevenson looking for an option. Colin Nish had Wesolowski to contend with. Nish gets another chance though, and he's going to go for it. Oh, what a tremendous strike! Colin Nish has struggled for goals lately. Not so you'd notice. That was an absolute stunner. Out of the blue, it's given Hibs an early lead.
Well, the ball pops out to Nish from a throw-in. it actually breaks for him quite kindly in the end. Takes a touch out of his feet, 25 yards out, and drills it right into the top corner. You just see here, it's pressure on the ball by John Rankin. Nish takes a touch. He should be closed down quicker, but absolutely nothing Lucas Zuluka can do about this, because this is right in the postage stamp.
Well, he'd gone 13 games without scoring. His last was against Celtic back in December. If you're going to break your drought, that's the way to do it. Dundee United stunned, but not much they could have done about a goal like that. Hibs haven't been conceding many goals then. They haven't been scoring any either, but Colin Nish has scored a screamer already at Tannadice. And Nish is in again to score again, surely! Dundee United made a terrible, terrible mess of it. And Nish has pounced again. And inside 10 minutes, Hibs have a 2-0 lead at Tannadice.
Well, I said before the game started that Dundee United had to defend better, and they haven't done any of the sort. It's just a ball popping around the box. Prince Bourbon's got to clear that. It falls nicely for Nish. Great composure to finish. But how many chances did Dundee United have to clear this ball? This should be way out of the picture, but it falls to Nish, and away it goes. Very tidy finish. Takes a touch away from Kenneth. Very composed. 2-0 Hibs.
Colin Nish has taken a kick on the head from Wesolowski. Well, you wait ages for a goal, and typically two come along at once. Stevenson. Russia. Dundee United a little slow to react again. Ryden is begging for it. It's not really an option now. Rocha for Nish, and Saluska denies him a hat-trick in the first quarter of an hour.
Well, Colin Nish is like a magnet at the moment. Every single ball that goes into the box is falling to him. For me, I think Rocha takes far too long to get the ball into the box, but it's a good bit of skill. A little drag onto his left, stands a good ball up to the far post. Good contact, and it's a great save by Saluska. Just see Rocha here, a little shimmy, lovely cross, decent volley and a good save.
Ryden's corner, cleared by Gary Kenneth. Rocha sends it back. John Rankin isn't allowed to, about to let Sandaza get the better of him. He's got a free kick.
Well, he did really well.
Gomez. Jones unable to clear it. Gomez persistent. Conway's cross. Penalty! Feeney went to ground as he grappled with Hogg. And Dundee United have a chance to fire themselves back into this game.
Well, again, it's Dundee United attacking Hibs down their left-hand side. Great ball in by Conway. Hogg is all over Feeney just outside the six-yard box. You can see he gets across him. He jumps too early, mistimes his jump. You could argue it's maybe a tad on the soft side, but certainly I think Hobbs just got to accept that he can't win the ball there.
It's Craig Conway, who scored from the spot against Falkirk not so long ago. But it's a very special save from Zamatolski against his former club to preserve Hibs' two-goal advantage.
Well, it's a phenomenal save, you can't argue with that. But I tell you what, he must be 3 or 4 yards off his line when he saves it.
It's a corner, which Conway himself will take. Warburn, unlucky, decent try.
Just have a look at Samotolski, comes off his line, look at that, way off his line when he makes a save. Keepers do that nowadays, but he does very, very well, guesses right. Conway picks his side. It's a good height for the keeper, but still a fantastic save. This is Samotolski, eyes on the ball.
It's the end of our first half that began with a bad injury to John Daly. Inside 10 minutes, Colin Nish had scored twice that second half, denied the chance of coming back into this game by Zamatolski's penalty save, but of course they should have had another penalty as well when Wesolowski was taken out by Rob Jones, and to rub salt into his wounds, he was given a yellow card as well. Dundee United, though, have liked a comeback or two over the past couple of seasons, and they need to mount another such charge now. Gomez. And it's a corner kick. Well, we saw them turn the game around against Celtic early in the second half here a fortnight ago. They were up and at the defending champions, and they will have to do the same to Hibs now. Conway's corner. Lee Wilkie rising, and Rob Jones with him. The battle of the big men. Gary Kennett preparing a long throw. Kenneth launches it towards Wilkie. This time Colin Nish is with him. Wilkie kept going. Sandaza. Gomez. Conway. And Lee Wilkie still in there! Oh, he's put it wide. That could have signalled the start of a great comeback.
Well, it's a great chance for Wilkie. He just pulls off his man, which is actually Lewis Stevenson. He's onside. It's a very tight angle. It's a very difficult finish because he's at full stretch. Lovely floated pass in by Conway. And he can't quite control the volley.
Dundee United have only won two of their last 22 league encounters with Hibs. They are somewhat of a bogey team.
And it's strange, really. I think Craig Levein once again will be relatively happy with the way his team has played with the ball, but defensively they've been so poor.
Fletcher, who should have made it 3-0. Colin Nish, who had hit his chances too to make it 3-0. He's offside. Dixon's cross. Kenneth, it's in! Dundee United eventually haul themselves back into this game through Gary Kenneth, and that has made it really, really interesting now at Tannadice.
Well, it's poor defending out wide by Hibs because they leave Rocha 2-for-1. It's a lovely little cross by Paul Dixon to the far stick. Poor defending. No one picking up Kenneth. All by himself, gets across his man. Good header back where the ball came from, and this is Dundee United well back into the game.
Gary Kenneth with his first goal for over a year, and Hibs defence breached for the first time in 5 matches, for the first time in over 7 hours. Boabin. O'Brien, he's let that run out. Dundee United now will look to score a second quickly, as they did against Celtic a fortnight ago. Bamba digs it out. Fletcher for O'Brien. Dundee United again short at the back, and Rankin is free, and so's Ryden. And he's picked out Derek Ryden, and he can't pick out Fletcher, and Hibs have made a hash of that. Gomez, Boabin, nicely done. It's Boabin, forcing Zamatolski to push it away from a corner. Dundee United really fancying it now. And we've been in this movie before. Conway quickly in, Hogg quickly out. Gomez, here's Swanson, straight at the keeper, and I think it was Colin Nish who got him in the initial shot. to Dundee United.
Well, this is where Dundee United have started to dominate in the middle of the park. Prince Bourbon pulls the trigger from a good 30 yards out. Decent save.
Gomez, Wilkie. Gomez. Perfect for Conway to have a go at Bamba. Just a throw. Dixon. Terrific from Dixon. Offside. There's a flag up as it's put behind anyway by Sandaza.
Well, I'm interested to see, one, if he's offside, and two, how he misses. I don't think he is offside. You can see Nish definitely playing him on. And it's an amazing miss, really, but in the end it didn't matter. But I've got to say, I'm not so sure the linesman was right on that occasion.
Chris Hogg being told to get a move on because he's taken the goal kicks, or Samotolski. Here's Conway. Oh, Sandaza was lurking and Hogg took it away from him. It's a corner kick as Dundee United pile on the pressure.
And again, it's Conway who's the architect. Great ball in. Hogg does really well to deal with it. Just gets himself in front of his man and helps the ball on its way. But they're really rocking now.
Dixon's corner. We'll drift away for a goal kick. Dundee United have scored some big boys to aim for. Conway. It's the Hibs big boy who cleared it, Rob Jones. Still 25 minutes remaining. The Hibs have conceded more goals from set pieces than any side in the SPL. Dixon floats that one in, but it's safely taken by Conway. Firm header away by Hogg. Not much Fletcher can do on his top. Conway again. Dundee United relentlessly pursuing an equaliser. That was awkward for Zamatolski. It's a corner kick.
Well, it was a bit awkward, but I think he could do a lot better with it. Ends up punching it away. For me, he's got to be catching on that. He's under no pressure whatsoever.
Craig Conway's corner. Zamatolski got a punch to it. Laban. A schoolboy at Dundee United, recently returned from injury. Warren Feeney, who came on early in the game to replace John Daly, who was stretched off with a serious knee injury, is himself replaced now by David Goodwillie, who scored for Scotland's under-21s in midweek. 3 years ago, he got a goal against Hibs that made him the youngest ever scorer in the SPL. He's got 10 minutes to find the mark in this game. Fletcher. Dylan Conway. Rob Jones was so interested in that. Conway. Dylan. Equalizer. Sandaza. Skipping away from Hogg. and forcing Zamatoski to push it away, and Dundee United are into double figures on the corner count now.
Well, he does everything right, Sandazza. Gets it onto his right foot. The only thing is guilty of maybe not hitting across the goal. Hits it to the keeper's near post, and in the end it's a comfortable save for Zamatoski.
Familiar sight this. Conway's corner. Wilkie! Bounced off Sandazza, punched away by Zamatoski. Conway again. Away by Fletcher. Swanson. I'm not quite sure what he had in mind there. O'Brien. Dixon. Conway. Lee Wilkie still a potential target. Dundee United digging deep. Conway. Robin. Here's Dixon. Wilkie. Nobody gambling on the knockdown. Dillon. And he's made a mess of it. Dixon. And Jones let it go.
Well, I'm amazed how much space they give Conway to get the cross in, and how much space Sandazza with the header. He gets free in the box. I've got to say, I think Zamatoski doesn't half make a meal of some of his saves. That was a fairly basic one. Low down, but he doesn't like mind pushing or punching away.
United and Gomez. Dixon for Wilkie. On for Conway. We're into stoppage time, and it's going to be yet another Dundee United corner. 5 minutes of added on time. Conway's corner. Wilkie watched it disappear away from him, and it's another corner.
I'm surprised at that. It didn't look as if it touched anyone, just went straight through. But Dundee United get a chance to keep the pressure on.
Dixon takes it. Sandazza trying to force it in. Wilkie there too. It's a massive bundle, and it's been put in by David Goodwillie. It's stoppage time, but you have to say Dundee United will feel they deserve that. They've shown their powers of recovery yet again.
Well, I think this is what's known as a stramash. The ball gets knocked into the box, they keep it alive. Hibbs never get the chance to clear it because it just pops around and eventually just finds himself in a yard of space, David Goodwillie, at the near post. Pulls off his man, hoping for something to pop out. It does, and he gets his foot in, manages just to get something on it. And eventually it managed to avoid Rosa at the near post, and in it goes.
He just managed to sneak that in. Stephen Fletcher, though. It's a good try, struck it really well, but straight at Zaluska. We've still got 2.5 minutes left of stoppage time. How many times have we seen Dundee United come back in games? Although Hibbs might dispute the fact that it was a corner, remember? Sandazza's cross. Suddenly Dundee United sniffing a winner, and that really would cap off an amazing game. Rankin makes a hash of the clearance. Conway. Swanson. Here's Dillon. Is there going to be another twist at Tannadice? Wilkie won it. He's gone back in defence now. Robin, and a free kick in a very promising position for Dundee United.
Well, you can't believe it, the problems Hibs are having. They can't even get to clear their lines. Rankin, who's been pressing the ball very well all game, he's given away another set piece in a really dangerous area. You've got to think that Dundee United are going to pull the trigger from here. Paul Dixon, he's a real expert on these.
Dixon scored his only goal for Dundee United with a free kick at Celtic. Conway is there too. 94 minutes, another minute left. It is going to be Conway. He's first to it now. Dundee United still searching for a winner. Gomez. Away by Rob Jones. Danny Swanson. Marvin stretching. Swanson. Dundee United have pummeled Hibs in this second half. Will they get one last chance? Dixon, ready to deliver now. Wilkie, just wide. He could have won it.
Well, I think it's safe to say that's going to be the last chance of the match. Great bit of play by Dixon. Stands a lovely ball up to the far post. And it's a free header for Lee Wilkie. That's meat and drink for him.
Well, that really would have put the cap on it, the seal on it. 5 minutes of stoppage time. It's been a highly eventful encounter at Tannadice, and it ends 2-2. Dundee United, the dominant force in the second half. They were 2-0 down inside 10 minutes. They responded rather well to that. They could have got themselves back in the game in the first half, but David Goodwillie came off the bench to save the day. Youngest SPL scorer when he got one against Hibs 3 years ago. Gary Kenneth started to come back after Colin Nish scored twice inside 4 minutes in the early part of the game. Colin Nish hadn't scored since December. Bang! Have a bit of that, Dundee United. And then, with less than 10 minutes on the clock, Nish pounced again after some dodgy defending. Dundee United had a penalty and should have been given another. This one from Craig Conway, saved by Zamatulski, once a Tannadice player. He was beaten, though, eventually by Gary Kenneth, and Dundee United absolutely swarm forward, searching for an equaliser. And after the mother of all goalmouth scrambles, David Goodwillie pinched that equaliser in stoppage time. Such an engaging encounter at Tannadice. It finishes Dundee United 2, Hibs 2.
Craig, you got a point here today. Do you feel that was the least your side deserved?
Yeah, probably. I would qualify that by saying I'm pretty biased. But second half performance was as good as we've played here for a long, long time. I just wish that we didn't need to keep giving ourselves the problem being goals behind at half-time.
Yes, is it frustrating that you are giving yourself that uphill battle to try and come back in the game?
Yeah, of course it is. And you know, I spoke about it after the game there. What, you know, do we need to change the warm-up? Do we need to do something different to get us off to a better start in matches? Because we keep having to come back from goals behind. So we need to have a look at that. But, you know, the biggest thing today was we looked down and out at half-time, 2-0 down. And, you know, in all honesty, we didn't play well at all. Second half, we're so, so much better. And, you know, all credit to the players. They're never beaten this. This team are never beaten. They keep going right to the final whistle.
And just finally, have you learned the extent of Daly's injury yet?
Well, it's a serious knee injury. He's in the hospital still. You know, when you see a player, like especially John Daly, who's a big, strong guy, and never complains about anything, when you see him banging the ground like that, I think the players are pretty distressed. And, you know, we just hope that the news is good, but I'm not so sure about that.
Thanks for your time and well done today.
OK, thank you.
And if that's representative of what, John, we're going to see for the rest of the SPL campaign, two teams wanting to win rather than not lose, then that's great. Nice 2-2 draw, and both Dundee United and Hibs still in the frame for Europe. From all of us here, bye for now.